Welcome to another video here on Cashed Out Cars. In today's video, we're going to be going over all the differences between the NB1 and the NB2 Miata, and we're going to be going over everything visually that's different and all the power and handling things that have changed between these two generations. We're going to start out with the visual stuff, and towards the end we'll get into the power and handling, so stick around for that, but for now, let's get right into it. This car here is a 2002 Special Edition Miata. This is my friend Matt's car over here. And then this car over here is a 1999 with some options. This is my personal car that I'm cleaning up and restoring. So this one doesn't look perfect yet, but it'll get there. Either way, this is going to be a good comparison. So to start out, my car over here, the NB1, has these taillights, which are different than the NB2 taillights. And as you can see, I mean, they're pretty obvious differences, but this sort of looks more like the NA taillight, whereas this is sort of a newer design with the clear plastics. Moving on to the front of the cars here, the NB1 has a much more open style front headlight here, and they're not projectors. These are just a standard bulb. They're nothing crazy, and a lot of people like to say these headlights are pretty bad. I could say that driving around at night, they're okay. They're not the best headlights I've used, but they're also not horrible. Going along with that, these headlights match up to a bumper that's specific to the NB1, so you can't take a NB1 bumper, put NB2 lights with it, and have everything match upright. Let's take a look at the NB2 lights over here. So as you can see, these are the projector style lights. These are supposed to be a lot better. I haven't driven this car at night, but they're supposed to be the much better headlight out of the two, and they do look a little bit different. Once again, the bumper on the NB2 does look different than on the NB1. It has a more sharp opening in the front there, whereas that's a more rounded design on the NB1. And this is really just sort of a personal preference thing. I like them both. I'm a fan of pretty much all Miatas, so I like to see both, and neither of them are a clear winner for me. Moving on to the interiors of these cars, the NB1 has less bolstered seats, and they're supposed to be a slightly thicker design than the NB2. I don't think these seats are particularly bad. I think they're fairly comfortable, but they don't hold me in great, whereas over on the NB2, which we'll take a look at right now, they're a slightly thinner seat, and there's more bolstering, and overall, the seat does hug me a little bit better. Now, the bolsters on my NB1 are slightly blown out from the previous owner, but regardless, this has bigger bolsters and this seat is a little bit more comfortable and it holds me in just a little bit better. Moving on, the steering wheel is just slightly different in the NB2. This one has the Mazda logo there, whereas my wheel in my NB1 has the Nardi logo on there. And this is another one that's just sort of personal preference. It's not a big difference, and they do feel pretty similar. Being a special edition, this does have the leather wrap in the center here that's a different color, but either way, the steering wheels are pretty similar. Now we could get to something that a lot of people like to complain about with the NB1, and I actually do see it as a problem in mine, and it's broken, and that is the center console. If you look at the center console here, there's no place for cup holders in the NB1, and the cup holders are actually inside the console right there. So if you want to have drinks in your NB1, you need this flipped up. And that makes it easy to hit this and this breaks. So that's what's going on with mine right now. Also, if your passenger has a drink, it's going to be more difficult for them to get to. And over on the NB2, that's been revised. And you could see that the cup holders are integrated into the console and are much nicer. The door cards are also slightly different on the NB2. They're a slightly different mold. You could see right there, there's the little crease. This pocket is molded slightly different, and the door speaker cutout is slightly different. Another thing is, if you have a car with power locks, there is a button on the NB2, whereas over on my NB1, there's no button for the power locks on the door. And to be honest with you, and correct me if I'm wrong, I haven't found a button inside the car to lock it. You just lock it by pushing these things in and out. And it locks and unlocks both sides. But back to the door cards, this is a slightly different mold. Once again, it's personal preference. I do like the NB2 one a little bit better than mine, the NB1, but it's not a big deal. On the inside here, an immediate thing that you'll notice when you get in both cars is the NB1 has black gauges. In the NB2, these gauges are white. Also, these are backlit red, whereas in my car, the NB1, they're backlit green. Another personal preference thing. To me, it doesn't make a huge difference. Both are pretty nice. And now we move on to power and performance of these absolute rocket ships of cars. So they have some benefits for both of the two versions. The NB1 does not come with the 6-speed, whereas the NB2 did have a 6-speed option. If you got a 6-speed and an NB2, you're going to get a 3.9 ratio rear end here in the States, whereas all of the NB1s came with a 4.3. If you're over in Europe, you could have got a 3.6 ratio rear end, so longer gears, but we didn't get that in the States and we have to get them from overseas. Also, the NB1 over here is not a variable valve timing engine. If you take a look, there's no extra little notch here for that variable valve timing, whereas on the NB2, you do have that notch. So this is basically the equivalent of VTEC for Hondas. It allows you to make more power throughout the whole RPM range. So this has a little bit more power throughout, whereas the NB1 over here, you really need to rev out a little bit more to get to the power. The head design on the NB1s is supposed to be the best flowing head that is on one of these 1.8 liter Miatas. And the NB2, although it has the variable valve timing and makes a little bit more power, is a slightly more restrictive design, and people tend to build the NB1s for spec Miata versus the NB2s when they have the choice. The ignition system is also different between the two. So this one has sort of a split coil on plug design, whereas some of them are coil on plug and the other sort of branch off of that. Whereas on the NB1, we have the older style design where we have the coil pack in the rear and wires running to each plug. I haven't personally had a problem, but I know I've read that people generally have some problems with these coil designs on the NB1s, but once again, I haven't had it. It's not like a catastrophic failure, but it's something that some people have reported. Moving towards the end of this video here, NB1s did not come with big brake kits from the factory. The NB2 did have an option for bigger sport brakes, and they became standard in, I believe, 2003, but I'll put that on the screen if that's incorrect. Now, this is just a slightly bigger brake design that has a little bit more mass and is supposed to be a little bit better. I haven't had big problems with these brakes, and they are definitely bigger than my NA6 brakes, but it is something to look out for. Another thing is the wheels on the NB2s were standard as 15-inch, whereas the NB1s had 14-inch wheels with 15-inch as an option. You also could get bigger wheels depending on the packages on these cars, but in general, it's a slightly different wheel design. If you're looking through, you'll see them, and that's just something to look out for when you're looking at these cars. And with all that, that's gonna wrap up this video. I wanna hear from you guys. Which car do you like better? Do you like the NB2, the NB1, or do you like different generations? Personally, I like literally all Miatas and they're all super fun for different reasons, but yeah, I wanna hear from you guys. Also, if you wanna see driving comparisons and actual on-road performance comparisons, subscribe to the channel because we'll have those down the line between the NB2, the NB1, my Turbo NA, and Matt's K-Swap NA once it's all set, hopefully soon, but we'll see. It's always a project with stuff like that. Also, if you want Miata shirts, I have them listed in the description down below. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe for more, and I hope you stick around for the next one. Take care.